Okay, people, today is kind of a big day. I'm about to jump on a plane to London from Portugal.
So I'm going to London because I started a new company. Started a company with Grace Beverly and a guy called Gary, and we're all meeting up in London to record a podcast because we're going to launch the company in like a week's time. So there's my taxi. I better get on the road.
Hola.
Obrigado.
London, Gatwick.
Hello.
Obrigado.
To meet you, welcome.
You don't mind now capturing some behind the scenes?
Not at all.
How are you?
Yeah, good, thank you.
Glastonbury fun?
Yeah.
What do you want to talk about first? Podcasts?
Yeah, we can do that.
The constraint is it has to have the word bot in it at some point.
Right.
So we have to get...
If we say no to all these launches and stuff...
Then we're going to give ourselves an excuse to slow down.
We're just kind of giving up, aren't
we? Okay.
I'm insanely late this morning, like very late, and...
We probably shouldn't dox Grace's office, actually.
Yeah.
So let's face this way. Okay, so we're here in London. This is the first time that since we've started Retrograde, myself, Grace, and Gary have been in the same room. The first time Gary's met Grace, we're here to record a podcast, and I guess kind of launch the company. Morning, Andy. How are
Retrograde.
You?
Retrograde.
Very well. How are you guys?
Good, thank you.
Friends.
Yeah.
Because then we have as much time as we need to...
Do the other stuff.
Do the other stuff. We can always move things around if needed. Perfect.
Morning, Grace. How are you?
Good, thank you. How are you?
Very good.
Jump fast. I switched this one up to give this to me. Watch my brother now. Why you can't? Hey, shut up. The boys ain't coming outside when I'm outside doing my dance. And I might jump.
How did you find like jumping in with like essentially two strangers in another country and founding a company?
Well, you got to take some risks sometimes. Like overall, because I feel like this is probably one of the craziest things I've done.
Come on, I know, live a little.
Boring, but I think that you know, like.
Do you?
I will get straight back onto you once I. Yeah, once I get my thoughts sorted, is that all right? Just landed from London, trying to catch the sunset. Busy few days, we recorded a podcast with Grace and Gary, got a little bit of planning done for the launch. I've got two more days here in Portugal before we go to Dublin, hopefully to wrap this all up and launch this baby. So that trip to London was pretty interesting in that it's the first time that I've seen Grace in person in years, and it's the first time that Gary's ever met her, and it's the first time we've ever all been together in the same place at the same time. So building a company remote is pretty hard. It's really hard to understand what people mean over text a lot of the time. And it just helps so much to see each other in person and just feel the energy in the room and try to understand the people. And it makes it a little bit easier then when you go back to your own countries to figure shit out. So hopefully that gives us a little bit of a speed boost. Not that we needed it because we're speeding. But yeah, I need to do that more often. And hopefully we don't sound too stupid on the podcast. Let's find out. Most productive place in the world, in my opinion.
Yeah.
Just lock in and grind. It's 4 in the morning. I've been awake since 1 a.m. I wouldn't say I'm having a panic attack, but because I've had panic attacks before, and this isn't one. What I would say I'm panicking. I'm flying to Dublin tomorrow morning. And I don't know why, but I just can't leave my baby. Like I've never left him for 3 days. And it sounds silly, but I just don't want to leave him. I'm not leaving him. I'm not going. I'm just canceling the trip. Right now, in my head, I'm just not going. I just can't go. Fuck. I kind of have to go, but I'm
I'm just not. Jesus Christ, I don't know what's going on.
Okay, here we go. Hola. Obrigado.
All exits must be clear for takeoff and again for landing. Please take a moment now to locate the nearest exit.
Back in the motherland. Isn't that how it always works? But this isn't like a rolling thing. Sorry, I'm good. I just had one of our investors on the call on the phone there with some last minute.
How was that?
It was sketchy, but it's good. We got it done. Do UK companies have company seals?
No.
Yeah. Ireland is
no seal.
Barbaric.
That's nuts.
Yeah, I literally have two seals in my suitcase.
Doesn't mean let me know that though. That's not a problem. It's more if it's just gonna fill up inboxes, just going back and forth on yes, no, do we like this? Yes, no.
He's here. He's here right now. If you want to do it, or we can wait.
I might as well do it.
You ready now? Get over here.
We'll do WhatsApp because that's probably going to be the.
Yeah.
Hello, Gary.
You know, how's it going?
All good.
What is my passwords?
Our new salesperson can't log into your laptop.
Let's record this, guys. Jake.
Possible plan to go to America in September.
Do you have a
big content house?
Oh my god.
You and Niall are so excited about that.
You have to do that.
I know. Niall's like, all Niall ever asked me about is,
you have to do that.
Still going to America? I think if I said Niall, we're sorry. Not going to.
On the weekend, I was looking at houses, up for rent.
I think Niall would go.
Oh my god.
Yeah.
Please, I would love that.
Well, you two are running it, so don't look at me.
Oh, 100%. Okay, fine.
We'll probably just
send sales and marketing. See ya.
Okay, just coming up to the end of a 1 hour walk in the pissing rain in Ireland. Busy day traveling, airplanes, airports, a lot of stress with investors, meeting a few new team members, catching up with Niall, working on the product, planning everything for the launch. This is about as, I would say this is as chaotic as it gets, but it's as chaotic as it's been for a long time. So gotta get back up to speed and, you know, a bit like going to the gym or running. You get out of shape, and my god, are we in training camp. We're getting in shape right now. So didn't have that many steps on the clock, didn't get a workout in, feeling anxious, feeling stressed, a lot going on, a lot of moving pieces, buying a house in Portugal, didn't want to leave Axe, didn't want to leave Kate, didn't want to come home, plus launching a business in 7 days, finishing a fundraising round, hiring people, just so much going on right now, all while you try and be a person yourself. So I said, fuck it, I don't care if it's raining. I need to get an hour walking done so I can just helps a lot. Walking helps a lot with all the head stuff. And if your head's not in the right place with this kind of thing, you're fucked. You're not gonna make it. There's no point working hard if your head's not in the right place, because you're gonna make a stupid decision, or you're gonna make a decision out of fear, or you're gonna take a shortcut, and that is not what we're here for. So I'm gonna get inside now, make a peppermint tea, call my wife, and get some sleep. Tomorrow's another day, and we've got a lot of fucking shit to do, so let's do it. Okay, good morning. It is 8 a.m. I had a little bit of a sleep in because, as heartbreaking as it was to leave the baby behind in Portugal, when the baby's not here, you get much better sleep. So
I slept. I was going to run. I was going to run, but then I just said, no, I'm going to sleep. I've got two or three mornings here. I can actually get some good sleep. Why would I wake up early when I can do that any other day? Well, I have no choice, actually. I have to do that any other day. So I'm drinking a coffee here, trying to wake up. I'm going to go drive to town now in 30 minutes to meet one of the investors who's part of this funding round, which is nice. I've never actually met them in person, just on the old video calls, Google Meets. So nice to put a real face to the name. And then, yeah, I've got a pretty busy day. I guess I should just really get on with it. I'm going to drink this coffee because I've got a headache. And, yeah, hate to be a complainer, but sometimes too much sleep can actually make you feel worse, nearly.
But it's not under any threshold, so
nothing to worry
about. Whoa. Oh, you changed my dress, Baba.
Hi. Hello.
In the night, he drinks less. He drinks 170.
That's because he's not thinking about it.
An itsy bitsy spider went up the spider again. Yay! Good boy!
Hey, Tata.
Hello!
Okay, good meeting in town with the investor. A lot has happened since then, which I have forgot to record. I got clamped leaving town, so I had to wait in town for like an hour, which was a disaster, and I couldn't even get a taxi out because I'd have to leave the car behind and it would get clamped again. So got unclamped, got home, met up with Gary and Niall at the house, did some work, grabbed a bit of food. It's like 2:30 now. I'm driving to see my doctor. He's a cardiologist. Even though there's nothing wrong with my heart, I take my health very seriously because I'm sort of a hypochondriac. So I'm gonna see him, a little bit of a checkup. I've got high cholesterol, so I take a statin, which is somewhat controversial for someone my age, but I reckon it's the right thing to do. So we're reviewing my blood tests to see if the statin has started to work or not. Okay, just saw the doctor. Everything is looking very good. The statins are working, and then it's straight back to the house for more work with Niall and Gary. So I messaged Gary on the 16th of September, 2023. Grace on the 5th of October, 2023. It's now the 23rd of July, 2024. I must have had this idea with you and Niall in Baggett Street in August.
Yeah, probably.
God, what a trick. Day two, in the bag. Gary, Niall, good job. Good morning, Nob.
Good morning.
How are you?
Good, how are you?
Got my coffee.
Same.
I'm ready. We can't waste 90 days to launch.
No.
Just not a chance. No, I don't think a day or two is okay. That big a deal. He's just so fucking sad. That was close. I was like, no, I can't wait till July, August 24th, September 24th, October 24th to launch.
That's crazy. So what's... Do you think you'll push back the podcast?
No, he seemed pretty keen we'd get it done this week, etc. I don't think so. I should probably email the PR agency and tell them.
Nearly there. Nearly there.
We were so close today.
Yeah.
I don't know. Everything I know about life came true today. Murphy's Law. Could easy be tonight though.
Yeah, you can get me a shout on the road down. I'll be stopping in a petrol station to find a printer.
That's when we can wait till you get on. Sure, Grace. Grace is probably on an airplane now. Jack Pierce is probably fucking halfway across.
I think you just go for it.
Yeah.
Looks alright. Yeah.
Okay, I'm just clearing the emails. Day three in Dublin. Pretty much complete, or at least coming to an end. I've still got a few more meetings this evening. Gotta go convince an engineer to join us because she already said she didn't want to join us, but I don't know how to take no for an answer, so I'm gonna go hopefully get her. But today was a pretty fucking messed up day. We were supposed to close the investment and sign all the documents, which is like a very big deal, and we've been working on it for months. And then
the investors ask for a tax clearance certificate, which is something that you have to like get from the revenue, which is like in Ireland, like the IRS or the HMRC in the UK. And we realized we didn't have any access to our revenue online portal, which of course requires us to get a letter sent to a physical address, which can take anywhere up to 5 days. So we had to like call a few people and pull a few favors and grease a few wheels. And now we might get the cert today, but we probably won't. We might get it tomorrow, but we might not. And we're launching in 3 days. And if we don't get the cert, we don't get the funding, we might have to delay the launch, which we've paid a lot of money for and we've been working towards. So I don't probably seem that stressed right now, but it was a pretty stressful day. It still is pretty stressful. So I'm biting our fingernails here and hoping that clock doesn't move too fast. I don't know what I'm going to do if we can't launch now. I was going to say rip all my hair out, but like it's, my hair's disappearing. My hair's disappearing fast enough. I probably shouldn't do that. We're up early tomorrow. Myself and Niall are flying back to Portugal. We've got a bit of last minute content to shoot before the launch. Tie up a few bows, get a bit of stuff done over there. And then I'll be in Portugal for the launch on Monday. Yeah, flying early tomorrow to Portugal, which is good because I flew Kate's mom to Portugal this morning to surprise her and her brother. I was pretty upset that I missed it, so I'm very excited to get back tomorrow. No emails. I can't think of how many times I've checked my emails today. Must be like well over 1,000. There's two relevant rules now. The first rule is not really a rule, it's a law. Murphy's Law. What can go wrong will go wrong every single time. They've been building this company since August 2023, it's been 11 months since I sat in Bag Street with you and sort of we mocked up the very first designs for Retrograde. But this fundraise has been going on since March, which actually isn't that long, but like, yeah, just the last day and we find out we need the clearance or but then the other law is the planning fallacy, which states that everything will take twice as long and cost twice as much as you think. And then you're gonna try and account for that and then it's gonna double again. It's just a fucking nightmare. But it's just the way of the world. It's just life. I'm not making this up. No. This happened today. It's real.
I see it.
First world problems for sure, but like fuck. So on Monday we are hopefully gonna be in a lot of press. We've got a big push gone out to a lot of people in different press, like a lot of cool publications, which I won't mention. We recorded a podcast over in London with Grace, myself and Gary, going through the whole journey and point and product of Retrograde. And then we've got a bunch of other content just going out. And it's just exciting. It's crazy. It's like a new company, Grace Beverly, big deal, co-founder. Retrograde itself is AI. We're disrupting an exciting industry in the creator space with brand deals. It's very much so needed. And we've raised a bunch of money. And it's just like kind of as exciting as a startup launch gets.
How does this launch feel compared to all the other launches you've had?
So the Go House Dublin launch was pretty crazy. Like it's pretty hard to even explain. It was like 12 people in a house in Dublin during the level 5 lockdown. And like it did go pretty crazy viral. Like I think like every TV show, newspaper, radio show called us. Like everybody was talking about it. Because Ireland's not that big a place. No. Then Go House America was pretty good, but honestly kind of anticlimactic compared to the Ireland one. Then Pueblo, we had literally already sold the company by the time we had announced it. It happened that fast. So the announcement was actually, the launch of the company was actually announcing we sold it, which is pretty weird. So this is like the first time I've, I guess, launched a tech company, because the last one I'd already sold before we launched it. But, and I've never done something with someone like Grace. So like normally when you launch a tech company, there's like, you know, LinkedIn posts, and you might get one or two articles in the papers, and like your mom and your friends will share it. But like this time we've got we're gonna have millions of eyeballs on day one. So
I don't know what to expect, but kind of leaving a little bit of hope that it's good. But I don't know. Don't be disappointed. I think people who go into launches being like really positive and hopeful and stuff is just kind of naive. Like, launches suck, don't they?
Yeah.
Most launches. It's just like, oh, cool. Nobody, actually nobody cares.
No.
Like, we care, but nobody else.
Unless it's like a DTC brand where you're buying the product, but a tech company is completely different.
But even DTC, like, no one really gives a fuck.
Yeah.
It's like, oh, new hairbrush launched.
Yeah.
Okay.
That's true.
Yeah, it's like, what if there's something like the spotlight effect, where like you think everyone, you know, you walk into like the gym or a classroom, you think everyone's looking at you.
Yeah.
Like, most people haven't even noticed you're there. But for you, it's like the biggest deal ever.
Yeah.
So launching your company, you're like, oh, this, you know, this thing isn't right, or this is the wrong shade of green, or like, we can't do it without this. And it's like, bro, no one's going to notice.
Nah.
Like, no one cares. So I always approach things like that. Because like, really, Monday we're launching the company, we've built the product, we've got the investment, we've got a great team, but it's kind of just the start line. People, I think, see people in the papers, they raise money, they think they're at the finish line. You're actually like at the starting line. It's like if you were going to open a coffee shop, you found a location, you've got enough money to buy a coffee machine, and like, now you have to open a coffee shop.
Yeah, now you have to sell coffee.
Now you actually have to open the shop and sell it.
Yeah.
And like, that's where we are. We're just about to open our shop and start selling coffees, which could go really wrong. I've no idea.
No one knows.
I've no fucking idea. Last minute decision. I'm going for dinner at 6:30 in town. We realize we need to buy a new camera so we can make this content. So we're going to run in quickly, buy camera, go to dinner. Niall's going to drive home in the traffic. Sorry, Niall.
Okay.
On our way to buy a camera. Have we deemed this camera unacceptable? On its way out.
It's on its way out.
What's wrong with it? Hey Gary, yeah, so the accountants have submitted the stuff to the revenue, so they're happy with everything. The accountants are happy, and we're literally just waiting for the revenue. So the accountant said it might come back today, but if not, they will call revenue in the morning, and they would be very surprised if we don't get that certificate tomorrow, which means hopefully sign docs tomorrow. So fingers crossed, but that's the update. Only later flight is an 11 PM flight. Is that what you're talking about? Cheers, no worries, enjoy.
Thanks very much.
Okay, he was good at sales, wasn't he?
He was.
Absolutely did us in. It's been a long time since I bought a camera.
I feel good.
I don't know, it feels like I've scratched an itch. I told myself I'd leave alone. Like a smoker picking up a pack of cigarettes. I'm back. I'd probably be selling this camera on average in 2 weeks. How long did I own I got the Meta headset thing, and I sold it 3 days later. Emailing the lawyers here on the airplane, and they think that we might be able to sign this morning. Orders a taxi. Let's go, Niall. Right now, we need to go to my house. I need to see my baby. We probably need to get some coffees.
Hi, buddy. That's my man. That's my man.
We've got lots of emails. So we've got AML clearance from the investors. We have lawyers saying okay. We have tax clearance cert. And I believe that means we're good to go.
Good to go.
Okay, so myself and Niall are going to run and get a quick coffee and a little bit of a snack because we were up early and we're hungry and we're tired. And then we're going to come back to the house, do some work. Kate's going for lunch with her family. We'll link up with them later. And hopefully we'll have made some good progress the next time we speak to you on
signing the deal. Oh fuck, okay. Me and Niall have been, we've been grinding. That's all we really ever do these days, is grind. We are gonna go get dinner soon.
Half an hour
with my family. So we probably won't record that. But we're grinding. No signatures on the investment yet. It's 5:30 on Thursday. Soon. Sometimes I drive by these houses and all, just to get a little bit of inspiration, a bit of motivation. They are fucking crazy. Okay, so it's 9 p.m. on Thursday, back in Portugal. We flew back today. We really, really thought we were gonna get the deal done there, but tiny last minute things that need to be fixed and people have to, you know, agree on them and all that stuff. So pretty confident we'll sign it tomorrow. Hopefully nice and early, so we can have it's Friday, so it'll be a nice Friday feeling. Might even order a takeaway. Go wild. A bit of an ice cream. I think we deserve an ice cream now.
Yeah.
It's been a good week. We deserve an ice cream. Please God, tomorrow we get the deal done. How many times? I think in this video we should just have a fucking
deal counter.
Pretty sure we're gonna sign the deal counter. Yeah. Good morning now.
Morning.
How are you?
Good, how are you?
I'm very good. Went for a run, nice and sunny. Good, yeah?
Yeah.
What did you do?
Chilled in my room.
Was the breakfast good?
It was alright.
Okay.
It was alright, yeah.
Just got a message from the investor. Docs. Documents. Agreed on their side. So.
What's left?
I think that just leaves the signing.
Sounds good.
How many counters on the signing the documents is that in this video?
Definitely lost count.
Maybe today, no. It might actually be today.
Let's go.
Wow. Okay, Niall and Jake have been grinding. I'm grinding so hard I've got 2 phones. That's how fucking hard I'm grinding. 2 phones. And, I don't know. It's getting kind of late in the afternoon. Maybe it doesn't work. We're going to sign today. Niall is going home to the airport soon. We have to go and get him some food while we wait for the emails to come in. Please God, the emails come in. Yeah, I don't know. Okay, it's Friday, it's 8:30. I made a big mistake. I know what time it is, Siri. I made a big mistake, I didn't realize till 6:30. And investment delayed. Not gonna be done tonight. Not gonna be ready in time for the launch, so we're gonna have to launch without the funding news. And hopefully get the investment done on Monday. I fucked up. But that's life. So I'm gonna end this video here. Next video will be the launch week. Fuck, that was a crazy week, and yeah, on to the next one.